Hi everyone, welcome to our new video. Today we find a new tutorial we want to introduce to you. You know, most people when they use Kali or use command prompt, sometimes they don't know that it's possible to increase the font size when they are maybe typing something on the command prompt. So sometimes it happens that even if you put on glasses, you can't see those tiny words. So it's possible to change your font to any size you want. So, but in most cases, when you finish doing that, you will, when you close the terminal, it's gonna go back to its default way of doing things. So for in that case, I'm going to show you a trick how to make your font a little bit bigger so that you can see to whatever size you want, so that you can see well and type well. So maybe the more you strain your eyes when you're watching something, the more the chances are to make them get damaged. So it's easier to see bigger letters than to see small letters, because you don't stress your eyes a lot to do that. So we're gonna show you in Kali, and I believe it could be the same in other Linux Linux flavors. So in here you can see whenever I tap, this is some thing I wanted to do. I'm 100% sure some people can see that text, some can't see it properly. So if you can't see it, then we're gonna show you what to do. But if you can see it, it's okay. But also it's good to make your terminal words to be a little bit bigger, close to whatever, maybe 17, 22 word font size, so that you keep your eyes not to pain you when after using the computer. So now this is gonna be one of the tricks I'm gonna show you, and I'm gonna show you a bonus trick, which is to turn your terminal in white or black. So I have a tutorial on that, but anyway, it doesn't cost me nothing to show you that. So preferences, when you're on preferences, you can then click here default light or dark. So that's the thing you want to do. Then that's where you can play. There are many options here to do stuff, but anyway, here what you're gonna do, if you wanna see these words bigger, so what you're going to do is to press you're gonna press Ctrl and the plus sign. Press Ctrl down, plus sign, and the plus sign. But sometimes plus sign is on the equal with the equal sign. So which means you're gonna press Ctrl Shift then the plus sign. But if you don't want that, you can put on switch on the num lock and try to use your plus sign on that other keyboard thing. Let me see if it can work. Plus, that plus, when I'm pressing the plus, doesn't work. But anyway, what you're gonna do, you're gonna use the plus sign on the default side of the keyboard, whereby you're going to press your Ctrl Shift then the plus sign. You can see becoming bigger. You can see here. So even if I delete here, I would say, hi, this font is great, don't ever change it. So in case, even if you write in some commands and you say ls, maybe you're gonna cd to downloads, if that is right. Yes, no such folder. Okay, cd to downloads, it doesn't want that. Okay, we there, then you ls, you can see everything you do now is big. You can see everything, you can see it's pretty good, because you can view anything, any letter you want. So once you're there, so now the problem is, once you close this, you go back and open your terminal. When you open your terminal, you can see now everything went back to normal. So whenever you close your terminal, it's gonna go back to normal. So Same thing you're gonna do, you're gonna press your Ctrl Shift, then a plus sign, plus sign, plus sign, plus sign, plus sign, then you start typing your CD to whatever, maybe you CD to home, and they say no, thing like that, CD to home, still, no, CD, it needs the, this, to home, no search file, what's going on, CD to home. Okay, now we can see it once more, letters and stuff. So then you can see ls, there was only one thing, one folder, then after that folder, then you see CD to that folder, which is, let me see, then you ls there, you can see all the information which is in there. So we navigated to that folder, into that folder, so using that what, the big font. So the big font really, size, font size really makes it easier for you to see and to do things quicker. So especially if you have a bigger screen, becomes so good, and also a smaller screen also the same thing, but a bigger screen also gives you more space to see stuff, because the font when they are big also they eat a lot of space. You might find some things go to the second line, you understand? So that's pretty much good. And how do we make it smaller? To maybe you made a mistake and press what, plus plus a lot. So you do the same trick, you say shift control, this time you're gonna say control only, and say minus, because the minus is with the underscore, and now the underscore was given, the minus was given more preference than the underscore. So in this case, if you press minus, it shows minus. If you want an underscore, you have to press shift and underscore, you can see. So but in case of the plus, if you press plus, it's gonna show the equal sign, but if you want the plus, then you're gonna press shift plus. So that simply means to access plus, you have to press shift, and to access minus, you don't have to press any shift, you get me? So this is the difference between these two. So now the command change, whereby when we want to, now the action's gonna change, the buttons we're going to press, they're going to change. Why? Because of the preferences they gave to these two buttons. So they believe most, I think most people press more equals than plus on the keyboard than to press the plus. So even compared to underscore and the minus, underscore is not much used, and underscore is not much used by most people who are using computer than the plus, the minus sign. So that's why here you're gonna just only press control, which is a CTRL, control with a minus sign. Minus, you can see minus, 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 minus. You can see now it's gone to the extent where you can't see nothing. You can see. So now you can go back and press your shift plus, 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 plus. You tell yourself, you know yourself where you can see properly. So you don't need to ask somebody which font should I use. Whatever you see that it's coming in well, like it's like we're zooming in, whatever you see, font you think it's relevant for you to see is where you stop. So if you see it's too big, you decrease using the same trick. If you see it's too small, you do also the same thing, you get me? So I think some Linux flavors, you can do that. They have some advanced features whereby you can just select some stuff and show you the font and select whatever, instead of pressing those keys, you get me? So to me, this is the best way. Also, you can learn more of those shortcuts by clicking on preferences, then you go to shortcuts. Everything's being brought for you here. You just read and say to zoom in, what do you do? To go to full screen, to zoom out, what you do? Find, what you do, whatever. So they at least explain and give you the shortcuts here, to open a new tab, to do whatever. Everything is here in your hands. So whatever I want to do, it's okay. You can click here and say this is the action, these are the short keys. So once you're done with that, then you can choose which ones you use most. But this is the thing we thought it's gonna be better for us to do a tutorial about. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe.